Today's adventure, N.S. Ned Steinberger, electric stand-up bass. They did give a little info on their website about it. It does have a truss rod. You can adjust the string height. I'm going to plug it in a little bit first before I monkey around with it, though.
It's kind of cool. Oh. Sounds more like a bass. And it's got this active passive. But I think it could play a lot easier. And just apparently this goes up and down. And it does have a truss rod, so I'm going to take it off the stand. And put it on the bench.
So they do publish an owner's manual. Talks about neck relief. First of all, though, we're just going to tune it up. It's got some neat stuff on the back, too. I'll show you in a minute. Here we'll look at the back. So that's how it strings through. I'm told these are the Dario strings. $125 a set. Yikes. But they put this so that if you had traditional stand-up bass strings, which would be much longer, they can be hooked into there, dragged through those holes and still utilized. I guess it's got a battery. It's got to have a battery for the active stuff. I think the newer ones have a rechargeable battery, so you just plug it in and I was reading within 60 seconds it will cook that battery up to the point that it will last for up to 16 hours after that. Interesting. All right, let's try and figure out what the neck relief is on this.
Okay, so I'm going to approach this the same way I would any guitar. I just hope my capo here gets big enough for me to clip this off. And nope, we're not going to make it. I got another one that might go a little bigger, but I doubt it.
Okay, wish me luck. Otherwise, I'm going with the surgical tube method.
Yeah, I don't have a capo big enough for that, but we have a solution.
Provided my surgical tube isn't all rotten and doesn't snap and hit me in the eye, this will do exactly what I want it to do. That's why it is Dave's World of Fun Stuff. Fun never ends. Okay, so we got rid of the nut. Let's see what else we got going on.
So, same sort of idea. We don't have any frets, but we'll fret it at the end of the usable portion of the fingerboard. And right now, there's some relief. What do we got? 11 thou, maybe? What about the treble side? What's going on? See, nothing there. So, thinking we need to release that a little bit, and then we'll lower the strings, and then it's going to work much better. Yeah. Well, the owner's manual says it's
6 mil.
Let's just look in there and see. Yeah, that's a big honker, all right.
Let's find it. Right, I'm way down here, folks. Okay, turns nice. Let's see what happens. All right then. Trouble sight was, see, that's better. There's some. Try something different here. Try something a little different here, folks. Just because we can. Although this straight edge isn't as long as I'd like it to be. Rightio then. All right. So they don't recommend the straight height, but we should at least try and measure one. And I guess I'm going to go with the 12th fret position, just for reference. And the string action's at 8/64. And 8/64. I think 6/64 would be really much nicer to play. And they've got these two Phillips screws on the back that let the bridge saddle up and down. And that's not a Phillips driver, Dave. So lower that, I guess. That's lowering. Retune it. See where we're at. Okay, what did we get? What we get is a sore arm holding this thing up on the bench. Still want to come down a shave. I'm gonna shave on both sides. Can I do it like this while I'm looking at it? And hearing it at the same time? We don't need to hear the string action. I like that a lot better. And the treble side still needs to come down a hair. Yeah, that's sweet. Yeah, already just fooling with it here on the bench. The playability is... what's that? What's going on here? Cable problems? Let's go put it back on the stand and see what happens.
Well, hell yeah.
Below. Thanks to my patrons, Facebook followers. I did relaunch the group. We're still missing about 6,000 people.
I don't know where they went, but they're gone. Subscribe. Links to things are below. Get a sticker. Most of all, be good to each other. Cheers, folks.